All right, so some of you might know that I just quit my data science job at FANG. The reason why I'm not saying explicitly which company, it's in case I need to go begging back for my job, you know, and I don't want them to say like, oh my God, why did you say this about our company? We're not gonna take you back. Now, before I go into why I quit my job, I kind of have to re-explain what my role was as a data scientist. And the reason why I have to re-explain it is because it's not as standardized as like software engineering, which is, I mean, I know I explained it in a lot of videos, but I'm just gonna do it again just so that you can have the right context to understand why I quit. So basically, this was my job title at this company. And yeah, so you can read it. So in essence, in my words, a data scientist is usually put into a product team. And usually in the product team, there's a product manager, there are software engineers, and there's a data scientist. Now, obviously there are other roles, you know, for example, like UX researchers and like product specialist, marketing people, legal people, and stuff like that. But I'm just gonna, you know, simplify it and say, okay, so there's software engineers, data scientists, and product managers. So I'm not gonna explain it in a way where it's like, oh, data scientists, they make models, they use like R, and like software engineers, they build infrastructure and they use programming languages, blah, blah, blah. I'm not gonna explain it like that. I'm gonna explain it in a more fundamental way of what their roles actually are. So engineers, they actually have the technical abilities to build the thing we actually want to build. Product managers, they're basically the leaders or like the owners of the product. They decide what the product is going to do and also what the product should be doing. Basically, they have the vision and they're in charge of actually executing, getting the shit done. And you know, they'll do whatever they need to do to actually ship a product. In some ways, you could think of them as like mini CEOs of a product or a feature. And then data scientists. We have the most time to think because we don't need to like build anything like for engineers and stuff like that. And we also don't need to focus on executing and talking to cross-functional partners all the time. So in some ways, because we're able to think more than those two counterparts, we're basically like advisors or like consultants of like the product. We don't actually make the final decisions and calls. I mean, obviously your opinions matter, but in essence, the people who had the final say are kind of the product managers and also the engineers, because the engineers are going to build it, so they could build whatever they want. And then product managers, they're the ones that decide on the future of the product. Now, because we have so much time to think, our job is to try to understand the product inside and out. We're supposed, well, technically, I'm not saying all data scientists do that, but I think that the fundamental role of a data scientist is to understand the product in and out better than anyone else. The reason is because, like I said, you have more time to think, you have more time in your hand. So basically we use data to try to understand exactly what the product needs and where the product should go in terms of the product direction. And what we can do is we can tell our team exactly where we should prioritize and how we should do certain things. Why? Because we have so much time to think about it. You know, we don't need to build stuff. We don't need to execute on anything. So that's our role. We're always making sure that the team is working on the most important things currently. Okay, I'll do one more analogy just because I like doing analogies. So imagine a YouTube channel, right? Engineers would be like video producers, which is the people who actually know how to make videos. Because in the end, if you don't have a video, you're not going to have a video channel. So I think of engineers like video producers. And then product managers, I think of product managers as the people who, well, it doesn't need to be multiple people, it could just be one person. But basically, the person who sends emails, tries to look for sponsorships, and they think about, okay, where should this channel go? Basically, they do everything that's not related to videos. You know, we got branding, we got sending emails, making websites, communicating with other YouTubers. Basically, just all the crap that video producers might not want to do. So I think those people are like the product managers. And then we got a data scientist. A data scientist would be kind of like an analyst of your YouTube channel. What an analyst would do is they always look at analytics to make sure that you know, you get some insights to know what kind of videos to make next. Like for example, they look at the views and they say like, oh, okay, you know, these things are kind of hot right now, or this is kind of trending. Yeah, you look at comments too. Basically, you're like, you're trying to understand your users the best way you can using data or anything, actually. It doesn't even matter. It doesn't even need to be data. So basically, those are the fundamental roles. Basically, a data scientist should figure out, you know, how to get more subscribers, how to get more views, and why are certain things working, why are certain things not working. So then give them insights, give the product manager or like the video producer insights into like, okay, what should you make next? How should we, you know, like these strategies. Okay, I know that was kind of long just to explain fundamentally what a data scientist is. Fuck, I need water. Shit. Okay, I'm too lazy to get water. Okay, but basically, the reason why I quit my data science job, in essence, it's because I'm still exploring. So I guess what I'm trying to say is a lot of people are content with their first job out of college. And for my case, I think that for the first years out of your college, it is totally okay to keep searching and try to understand yourself and try to understand what exactly is the right fit for you in terms of a job. Like I prioritize, well, I might be wrong, I don't know, but I prioritize long-term. Like for example, if you know I just stuck with data scientists and in the future I realize I hate the job, then the cost of switching jobs is a lot higher later on if I was already 5 years or 6 years in. So I do think that sacrificing the first few years trying to discover what you actually want is definitely beneficial for your career. Hopefully, I don't know, we'll see. So I'm not saying, oh, by the way, I'm switching to software engineering. I have a feeling that some people don't know, but I'm not saying that software engineering is my true calling or that this is the final job that I want. I don't know, I'm not sure, I might be wrong. You know, I might not even last for like another year or two. But in the current state that I am right now, I feel that I don't want to do, you know, the analytics part, like, you know, the YouTube guy where he just looks at analytics. I kind of want to make videos. I want to be a video producer. So in this analogy, it means that I want to build things. And I think that's currently what I want, at least what I think I want. So that's why I'm going to try out software engineering now. And yeah, because I thought that I was always a builder. And, you know, I do like some aspects of data scientists, but you know, I want to try to build stuff this time. Like, I think at the core, my personality does fit more of a builder. You know, I do like building stuff, but yeah. So yeah, so those are the arguments of me wanting to become a software engineer. So I'm gonna talk about some things about why I don't wanna be a data scientist anymore. So at least at my company or my old company, the way you get evaluated, no matter what role you have, is how much impact you have. And basically what impact means is, did you have like a positive contribution to the company? So even if you worked your ass off or you did, you know, you do a lot of smart, intelligent things, but it doesn't have any positive impact to the company or like it doesn't really change anything, then you still might get fired after a while. So as a data scientist, using the scope that I talked about, like the fundamental roles, basically, how a data scientist can have impact in a company like that is by influencing the product direction. So for a data scientist, using that scope of like fundamental roles, a data scientist, how they can have impact is by, you know, making analysis or something such that it leads into actionable insight, meaning that people will use that insight and then they'll take action towards it and then it will benefit the company. So that's impact. All right, so I have a few examples. I'm just gonna read it out loud because I can't remember them. So basically, in a simple way, if your analysis convinced the engineers to build something and our metrics went up, that's impact. Also, if your analysis convinced the PM and the team to put a new feature or a project on the roadmap, that's impact. If you create an amazing prediction algorithm to predict whether a user watched a video with alone in their apartment or with friends, but the team didn't decide to implement it because they don't think it's useful, that is not impact. If you found that Korea is a growing market for live videos and you have tons of evidence that adding a donation button can make your company dominant in the live video market in Korea, but even with their sound evidence, you cannot convince your product team to focus on Korea, that is not impact. So as you can see, it's not always 100% fair because for some team, it might be easier than another. And there's a lot of factor that plays into the success of a data scientist, and some of them are out of your control. And that was one thing that I found a little bit harder to cope with. Now, I've worked with teams where it was really, really easy to find opportunities, and then you show those opportunities to them and then they're super excited and they'll do it, you know, and that's a lot of impact. But I've also worked for teams that move a lot slower, I guess, more friction, and basically, you know, you don't have as much credibility to them, and it's a lot more difficult to convince them to do what you want to do. So that's why it's a little bit harder. So, and basically, if you have no influence, you don't have impact as a data scientist. Now, sometimes you might be lucky that your work is so good that your work speaks for itself, right? But the reality is that in life, that's not always the case. Sometimes you just have to be influential. Basically, you have to have the skills to influence your peers, your engineering manager, the product manager. You have to get them in the same team as you, or basically you have to kind of convince them that your ideas are good and that they should implement it. But that's the thing. It doesn't always happen. And sometimes you got to be pretty good at like the office politics or like, you know, stuff that are more like soft skills-ish. And I believe those were the skills I lacked, or at least that's what I thought before, and which made me kind of like, eh. Like, believe it or not, I'm actually kind of like a work introvert. So I'm also like still very inexperienced in understanding like the work dynamics and also like some office politics and stuff like that. I'm still quite new. So, I mean, I did get better, but at the time, that was what made me want to switch to software engineering, because I felt like I wasn't ready to be a product leader on my team. I didn't feel like I had the maturity to make and influence decisions on my team. I didn't have the confidence in myself nor my work, and that stressed me out. Yeah, that stressed me out. Now, don't get me wrong. There's a lot of aspects of data science that I enjoyed and that I like and that I still like. And I do hope that when I work as a SWE, that I could use some of the things that I've learned and use it as my advantage. But basically, how I think about it, like my philosophy is that your goal shouldn't be like, oh, I should be a really good data scientist, or I should be a really good software engineer. You should be the ultimate worker. Okay, that sounds kind of weird, but basically what I'm trying to say is you want to be the guy who can solve everything with anything, right? Like if there's a problem, you're the guy to solve it, no matter if it's a technical problem, a business problem, or like an analytics problem and stuff like that. You want to be the guy that people can depend on, and that's the person that I'm trying to be. And for now, the skills I want to work on are, you know, building skills like a software engineer. So yeah, I mean, I haven't done that in ages. I kind of miss it. Okay, so now what? You know, what am I doing now? Well, I am unemployed. So basically what I do is every day I just sit on my ass and I work on interview problems. What else have I been doing? Yeah, so, you know, because I have so much time in my hands, I've been going to Blind a lot. Blind is this like anonymous forum app that you can check. You could check like gossip. So basically when I worked at like my company X, what I could have done is I could have gone to Blind and see what other people were talking about that also worked at company X. So basically lots of gossip, but I also use it for non-gossip. And there's a lot of stuff that you can read about in like normal topics where just a bunch of people from Silicon Valley, they just talk about random stuff. And most of the time they talk about, you know, switching company, interviewing at their TC, total compensation, how much they make. It's a good way for me to get a feel of what the market is like right now. So I use it a lot, almost obsessively. A lot of the times I check like, okay, you know, company X interview process to kind of get a feel of like how they interview you. So that's what I do. I mean, you guys should totally check it out. It's pretty cool. Yeah, lots of anonymous talks there. Yeah, so basically, you know, I get a lot of questions sometimes from people saying like, oh, how should I do X, or what should I do to find X, Y, or whatever. Oh, wait, my camera's almost dying. Yeah, so pretty much like I get a lot of questions where sometimes I don't even know the answer, but how do I get the answers? You know, I go to Google, I go to, you know, Algo Expert to learn some stuff. I use Blind to understand how the interview process are like. I use a lot of these websites. So I feel like, you know, instead of me answering all the questions for you guys, I should just give you the tools to answer these questions, right? So there's this quote, you know what they say, give a man a fish and you feed him for a day. teach a man how to use blind, and they'll get into a career and buy organic fish from Whole Foods for a lifetime. All right, that's all I have to say for today. Thanks for watching. Peace. Forgot that feeling. The sun in my face, it's so well.